After reviewing the 16-inch MacBook Pro in my previous video, I guess I never realized how many people didn't know what Bootcamp was, Apple's integrated way of installing Windows for completely free. So if you're someone who either has a Mac and has never heard of Bootcamp or is thinking of getting a Mac, stay tuned in this video because I'm going to be talking about what Bootcamp is, what its uses are, and why I think everyone should be using it. Bootcamp is Apple's software that is integrated into all Macs post-2009, and what it does is allows you to partition off your hard drive. In other words, it allows you to take some amount of space and allocate it over for Windows and leave some space for macOS. What this will allow you to do is when you restart your computer, it will ask you, do you want to go to Windows or do you want to go to macOS? And the good thing about this is that since you're allocating some amount of space, if you install something on Windows, that means it won't show up on macOS because the spaces are completely different now. In this video, I'm not going to be going over how to install it because there's already a ton of videos that show you how to do it, but I will go over the process of what my personal experience installing it. And what I'll say is that, first of all, the installation is very easy. A lot of it's just clicking two buttons, waiting a 5 minutes for it to download, and then just rinsing and repeating. And basically, in no time, you're going to be loading into Windows like you just bought a new Windows computer. It's going to tell you to set that all up and stuff like that. While we're on this topic, let's go over pricing. So this is completely free, technically, because when you load into Windows, like you load into any computer, had you bought a new Windows computer, it would already come with a product key, meaning that Windows would be completely activated by default. However, since you're downloading Windows off the internet, the issue that you run into is that Windows won't be completely activated until you buy a product key. Now, if you're going to be using this a lot, I would recommend that you get the product key, but otherwise, you could be completely fine, like I am, using the free Windows system. So, obviously, doing this for free does come with a few restrictions on Windows end, and the two that I've seen are that, one, you can't change your background on your computer, which to me isn't the biggest deal. It's not like I'm staring at the background of Windows all day. And the second thing is that around 4 to 5 hours, you're going to get a message at the bottom right of your computer saying to activate Windows. However, the message is not permanent and it will go away every time you restart your computer. Usually for me, what I was running into was that 5 hours was maybe the maximum that I'd be using Windows at one given time in one sitting. So by that time that message came up, I was, you know, already about to log off, so it wasn't the biggest deal for me. Now let's talk usability. So if you bought a Mac computer, you're going to be thinking, why would I ever want to be using Windows? Because I obviously bought a Mac. And while I love macOS and I definitely prefer it over Windows, it does come with some weaknesses. And the biggest one that to me was software locks. Buying a Mac has its issues because a lot of stuff is restricted to Windows only. And even on Windows, there's a lot of stuff that's restricted to Apple only. But using this system, which I, like I said, is completely free, why not just get rid of those software locks? The biggest software lock that you're going to be seeing is going to be in the gaming world, especially for AAA titles. You're not going to be able to play most of those games. I've definitely seen a lot of this on Reddit where people are asking, can I run this game? Can I run this game? And the problem usually is not about can your computer run it. It's the issue is that can it run on macOS? And the answer is usually always no for 90% of the games. So before you buy macOS and expect to be playing all the AAA titles, make sure to check if macOS can run it, and if not, you're going to be wanting to use Bootcamp. Another issue that is solved in the gaming world with Bootcamp is the fact that as macOS keeps getting updated, it starts not supporting older indie games, and by using Bootcamp, you can totally just run every single game, even if it's like 10, 20 years old. But if you try running those games on macOS, a lot of times it's going to say it doesn't support it on the newest version of macOS. There is some ways to get around these restrictions in macOS, especially in the gaming world, using some virtualization tools like GeForce Now and Google Stadia. But both of these options are, one, paid, and two, require a very, very good internet to work correctly. But then you have to ask yourself, why would I use those paid options when I can just install Bootcamp really easily for completely free, switch over to Windows when I want to, play some games, you know, all the software locks go away, and then come back over to macOS when I'm done playing games. Another benefit that a lot of people are going to see is that if you're a Mac user who bought Mac just for work stuff and just stuff that you needed to just do on Mac that you couldn't do on Windows, you're going to like that if you're a person who preferred the Windows UI, then you can just, you know, start using Windows full time if that's what you want to do. Then you can just start using macOS as the less preferred option. That's completely fine. To me, this being a free system, I think there is no reason that you shouldn't be taking advantage of this. It took me a pretty long time to realize that this was even a thing. And as soon as I got it, I'm so happy with it. I haven't run into any issues. I think there's no reason you shouldn't be using it because, well, it's free. It gives you a lot of stuff that, you know, that you couldn't do on macOS. And I just think that overall, it's just such a great thing to be using. The only real weakness, or the only thing that you're really using up by doing this, is your memory. So what I learned about this is that there is a way to use a external memory drive for Windows and just, you know, hook that in so that you're not using up your space for macOS if you want to just keep using both. And this is a completely viable thing. I will say that it is not as easy to install Bootcamp on a external memory drive, but it is definitely possible. I've definitely seen a lot of people do it and they love it. Overall, Bootcamp is such a great thing, and I hope more people start taking advantage of it. If you have any other questions about Bootcamp or just Macs in general, make sure to leave it down in the comments down below, and I will be sure to answer them as quick as possible. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and I hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you guys in the next video.